कि जिन फसल धंधे का कर प्रेसिडेंट नेशनल फेडरेशन ऑफ द क्रॉप्स एंड शुगर फैक्ट्रीज सीसीएल पाटिल चेयरमैन ऑफ द महाराष्ट्र स्टेट क्रॉप्स एंड शुगर फैक्ट्री members of the state legislature, dignitaries who are coming from different countries, members of the legislative council, colleagues from Vasandhara Sugar Institute, Mr. Nastaji, Director Data Agro, who is going to deliver keynote address here, Dr. Serino, Secretary, International Consortium of Sugar and Biotechnology, Mr. Michael Waterfield, Scientific Affairs Manager, CTC, Mr. Sanjay Awasthi, President Sugar Technology Association of the India, Mr. Bhad, President Deccan Sugar Technology Association, Mr. Tenapa, the South Indian Sugar Cane and Sugar Technology Association, members of the Trust, members of the Governing Council, Chairman and Board of Directors, and Managing Directors of the Co-operative Sugar Mills and Fire Sugar Mills, Heads of Research Organization, Distinguished Speakers, Sponsors, Exhibitors, Participants, and Sugarcane Growers. It gives me immense pleasure to welcome you all to this third international conference and exhibition being held on the campus of this institute. After the successful conduct of the last two international conferences in 2016 and 2020, we are here together to discuss and deliberate all related issues ranging from agriculture to sugar processing and development of byproducts such as alcohol, biofuel, ethanol, and food generation. We all know the under-visionary leadership of late Vasandhara Patil, sugarcane growers of cooperative sugar mills founded this organization in 1975 with the purpose to provide skilled technical manpower for the sugar industry and provide technical support and guidance to the cane grower as well. Vasandhara Sugar Institute has thus provided interactive forum for all segments of sugar and allied industries and the sugarcane farming community. It is the unique kind of institution in the world as all disciplines connected with cane, sugar, and byproduct function in coordination under one roof. In India, about 50 million farmers are engaged in the sugarcane cultivation of the area of 5 million hectares. This sector faces various challenges of biotech and biotech nature, along with infrastructure issues. These issues can be addressed by evolving the farm management system that employs the latest tools like artificial intelligence, sensor technology, GIS, robotics. I am confident that the precision agriculture can well be brought about by introducing this latest technology so as to create the farm of the future. Considering the national concern for the food security and the requirement of land for food grain crops with the emerging technology, we can achieve enhanced productivity per unit of land and higher sugar equity. I also see the need to give more emphasis for biotechnology, nanotechnology, molecular biology, the next generation sequencing of genome and transgenic technology, as the sugar production is affected by climatic change, resulting in reducing the yield of sugarcane. Another important factor is that the sugar mills have been increasing the crushing capacity year by year, with almost same sugarcane production, resulting shortening the crushing period from 160 days to 120 days. Therefore, around 200 days, the entire sugar mill machinery and manpower remain idle during the crushing season, resulting overall the production rate. With the changing time, the sugar mill needs to find out the way to utilize resources by diversifying portfolio to production of hydrogen, ethanol, compass, biogas, hydrogen, aviation fuel, and other products, etc. I must also appreciate Mr. Gadkari, Union Minister for Road and Transport and Highways, who is arriving here today at the afternoon for his work to policy on ethanol blending. The sugar industry has made substantial investment and supply 5,000 million of liters ethanol in the last year and achieved 12% blending. The sugar mills have to generate revenue to the tune of ₹940 million from the sale of ethanol. This program has enabled the government to save about 240 million rupees of foreign exchange. I am only concerned with the policy fluctuation. That, in fact, the new establishment of ethanol production, once such a notification from directors of sugar directing not to use sugarcane juice and syrup for the ethanol has created ripple in sugar mills and distilleries. I express thanks to central government for immediately taking corrective actions. It was the huge relief for the industry. Apart from ethanol blending, we are looking forward to adopt new technologies like green hydrogen, which is destined to the fuel of future. The green hydrogen is amazing cleaner and efficient fuel on the produced only from water instead of CO2, and also gives 3 times better emissions. I would urge to scientific community to make the affordable in sugar industry. The institute is exploring the possibility of using electric power available from cogeneration to produce green hydrogen by using water. And I would request to visit the demo plant shown in this exhibition. The conference has received overwhelming response from scientists, research scholars, change growers, and manufacturers across the world. I am very happy to welcome the participants, eminent scholars, researchers, and cane growers from the Argentina, Australia, Brazil, Belgium, China, Denmark, France, Fiji, Germany, Ireland, Italy, Japan, Malawi, Nigeria, Netherlands, Norway, Oman, Philippines, Sri Lanka, Sweden, Switzerland, South Africa, Thailand, USA, United Kingdom, Uganda, and Vietnam. I'm sure that all delegates will benefit from this conference, the Sugar Expo, and live crowd demonstration. During the interaction, solution of different issues before the industry can be conceptualized that will pave the way forward for the progress. We should visit fruitful and informative delegation in this conversation and a pleasant and comfortable stay in Pune and India. Thank you very much.